Hello and welcome to my new project.
Life is strange before the storm. Part 1.
I enjoyed the original so much, I thought, why not?
Uh-oh.
What's going on? Those darn hoodies, standing right in the path of an oncoming train. Phew, that was close. It's Chloe. Her hair, it's all normal.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes. Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
What are we doing out here? So late. Nope, she is not going that way.
All right, let us venture forward. So this is a prequel to the original game. Before Chloe and Max reunited.
What's this?
A fence? Nothing's gonna stop me.
Whoa, the attitude.
Holy shit.
Where are we?
This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Maybe. But first, I must explore. Look at all the cars. I like the pickup truck.
I should get a pickup truck.
But first, let's go over here and look at this thing.
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
No idea. This place looks knackered.
Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
Aww, flowers!
Look at all these bikes.
I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends.
Chloe, you have no friends.
How sad.
Don't worry, we'll make you some friends. Humans, inanimate objects, whatever it takes. What's going on in there?
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
Yeah! They can't keep me out.
A second door inside? So close, and yet so far.
Maybe I can smuggle myself in.
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years.
Pretend to be a dog.
Unless I burn the bouncer.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
Might be a bit extreme. Let us ponder.
Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home.
Wow.
Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home.
This is the perfect place to solve a mystery. I bet it was
that guy.
Those excuses at him. But it really wasn't my fault.
Those guys need to get a room.
Cool. How romantic.
Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
Sorry.
I'm just gonna go over here. Really, this RV looks familiar.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Chloe, are you suggesting that we vandalize this poor defenseless RV? That's madness!
I hope no one sees me.
Graffiti.
Now what to draw?
Well, there's no competition. Free candy! Huh. Chloe, you're such a troublemaker!
Hey kids! Free candy.
Well, we earned a trophy.
Great! The owner of this RV will think twice before parking his RV anywhere near Arcadia Bay.
Whoa! Wow! That was good. We can change cameras.
Camera one. Camera two. Camera one. Camera two.
And now we know we can do this, we are ready for anything. Hello,
man guarding the door. Stand aside.
Please?
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid, but you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Check it, I'm totally legit. Come on, Chloe, you have to do better than that.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
Just walk past him.
Keep walking, kid.
Don't make Chloe get angsty. If there's one thing that we know Chloe can do, it's be angsty and guilt trip people.
An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here.
All right, let me in or I'll run you over with a lumber car.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
I want your clothes, your boots, and your motorcycle.
Is that your bike over there?
Yep.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
You've got funny ears.
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Listen, mate, let me in right now! You've started a backtalk challenge.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
Oh, that's a crazy stare, Chloe. Okay. So we must manipulate him with insults.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
You didn't. Okay. We're going to challenge this with a witty response.
Aww, isn't it past yours?
Ooh.
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Cute? I don't do cute.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
She kind of looks cute, but I wouldn't argue.
Maybe I am a kid, because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
I need protecting. Besides, you've got flowers on your bike.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look... My boss decides who gets in, all right?
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
If Chloe was a guy, she'd probably be squished into the ground by now, but it worked. We're in.
This is intense.
Shit.
Hey, Delia, come.
Cute dog.
Doggy. Had the dog slip past the bouncer. It must have really convincing ID. Question everything.
Why?
Oh god. Look at this place. People. Humans. I'm not sure about this.
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
No, I'm gonna leave. There's no going back. Okay, let's go and talk to the dog.
What's her name?
Delia.
Aww. I like you.
She doesn't usually like people.
Yeah. Me neither.
She's just as cute as Pompadour.
Sober up, girl. You're missing the show. Don't mess with Damon. Thanks for the memo.
Who's Damon? T-shirts. You can never have too many T-shirts.
$20, baby.
$20? That's robbery. And don't call me baby.
Fine. $20, thief.
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
You don't mean purchase alternative outfits as part of a DLC?
Ha! No, only suckers do stuff like that.
Parking brake. No need to think about what I'm doing too much.
Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Am I about to do this?
Yes, I am.
No! Come on!
Serves you right for trying to sell stuff for money. I'm entitled. You should give it to me for free.
Thanks for playing, dick.
He's talking to the trucker. I remember him. He still seems to be wearing the same shirt.
Oh, yeah. Sweet, sweet victory.
Unlike the trucker, Chloe occasionally changes her clothes. So we have a new shirt.
That's like $200.
Whoa. Steal the money? What kind of person do you take me for?
Oops. Some things never change.
Holy shit. I'm rich.
And we got away with it too. This is brilliant. We can spend this money on shirts and one-way tickets out of Arcadia Bay. I mean, there's nothing for us here. Chloe doesn't even have any friends. Let's make friends with this guy.
Hello, human.
Sketch Central.
Oh, I see. He doesn't want to talk to me. Fine. I'll just go over here and drink this bottle of stuff. Blech. I prefer Dr. Pepper.
Drink more, feel less. Yes, please.
This is the life. I'm going to have so much fun tonight, I'm not even going to remember having it. I'm one of the cool kids now. I'm going to walk up these stairs because that's what I'm all about. Shock!
Half those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey.
Never mind.
Frank!
Yo, Frank!
Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
God, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
No, peer pressure.
I don't even know what the internet is.
So, you come here a lot, or...?
Yeah.
Right. It's cool.
I'm really glad you approve.
You're a jerk.
I'll see you later.
Whatever.
How unfriendly. You're lucky you like dogs. I'll let you off this time.
Don't you judge me, spooky deerhead. I'm here for the band.
I want his glowing eyes.
Reminds me of the way I make important life choices.
Impulsively?
Whoa! That guy's face was really close to the camera then.
Hi, chill girl.
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
Probably because I've got the music volume turned right down. Because adverts are annoying.
Graffiti everywhere. I think they missed a spot.
So Max's thing is to take photos. Chloe desecrates everything she sees. What a vandal.
We're going to draw an evil eye.
What are you looking at?
It's beautiful.
I'm surprised we haven't been kicked out yet.
300 dock workers laid off, their pensions cancelled? God, Prescott's a real tool.
The Prescotts. Not a nice bunch.
That's totally me in 5 beers. Okay, 3.
You lightweight! But enough about intoxicated incompetence, we are here to see a band. I love going to gigs.
Damn, there are a lot of people here. Here we go.
Let's shuffle through. Excuse me, pardon me. Oops.
Ugh, fuck.
Sorry.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
I don't like the way he's standing in my path. Let's work our charm.
Fuck off, man.
Hey, you don't know who I am, do you?
No. And I give zero shits.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine.
What?
Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
We may as well try. Came all this way to see the band. New dialogue unlocked.
She returns.
Hello, it is I.
Who is that guy? He's a jerk.
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
We're crossing the wrong people already. Great.
Where do those stairs go?
Up?
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
Oh, the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine. I'll see you later.
Whatever.
It's not exactly sectioned off. Not that Chloe would care, even if it was. At the start of this game, she jumped over a fence like it was nothing. Chloe will bypass fences, bouncers, rotten stairways. It doesn't matter. Ooh.
Careful.
I hope the floor doesn't give way. That'd be embarrassing.
Fuck, yes! Finally made it! I can't believe it!
This is fantastic! I have the balcony all to myself, and a pretty good view.
Not that Chloe's watching the band, she's just feeling the music.
Although I have to say, doing music academically kind of ruins the way you enjoy bands. Chloe is enjoying this band in her own way, but I hate to break it to her, but this band is miming, clearly. Their guitars have no leads.
I'm triggered now.
Where is their wireless transmitter? I paid good money to go and see this band.
Well, I didn't, but
if I did, I'd be very, very annoyed. Very annoyed indeed. But at least Chloe's enjoying herself.
That's all that matters.
I've never gone to a gig and laid down. I mean, one, that'd be weird. And two, people would, you know, tread on you. I went to a gig the other day, and I was right at the front. It was great. Uh-oh, Chloe, get up.
You spilled my beer, bitch.
I knew this was gonna happen. What do you guys want?
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
And I don't like your vest.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Hey, dickhead.
Someone's coming to rescue me. Let's go down in glory. Nasty. Hey! Ow!
Rachel? Come on! Hurry up!
Ooh, I wonder what's gonna happen. Frank! Oh, he's gonna look out for us.
Let me go, Frank!
Not gonna happen. Calm down.
Come on, man!
Walk away.
Screw this. bullshit.
Get the fuck out of here!
So Chloe got to enjoy the gig after all. Thanks to Frank. He must have a thing for Chloe. Or Rachel.
Nah, must be Chloe.
Because Chloe is the main character. And I know this place. Chloe's bedroom. But it's tidier. Not tidy, but tidier. But this is an origin story. We might find out when exactly she ordered the pizza that sat around in her bedroom for the duration of the entire original game. The questions the fans want to know. But at least we got home safe from those nutters. Chloe has a good front, but when they were advancing on her, she seemed a bit worried. I mean, talking the talk's one thing, but if it doesn't work... And Chloe, that is a terrible habit. I mean, really, we already know she buys pot from Frank, she's smoking, she drunk at that place, snuck out. She makes rude gestures. She's already quite the rebel. Life is Strange Before the Storm, Episode 1, Awake. And I am sick of this. Put that cigarette out, it's time to wake up. Disgusting. Why can't you pick up a healthy bad habit like eating chocolate? Chocolate's good. I like chocolate.
Sometimes all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell.
The world isn't listening.
Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise, right?
Ah, William, Chloe's dad.
Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Aw, Max the loser. Yeah, that's right. I called you a loser. Wanna know why? Because you weren't at the firewalk last night. Even Frank was there. He's my dealer. Or, Mum, if you're reading this, he's my dealer and you shouldn't be reading this. It was maybe the greatest night of my life. I hiked to this old mill using the train tracks, then verbally abused this dumb bouncer until he let me inside. Firewalk was great. Who knew ragers like that went down in little old Arcadia Bay? I got black eye as a souvenir, but I got rescued by the most popular girl at school. How was your night, loser? Basically, going to see Firewalk was better than you, Max. Now this is more like it! Here I can write to you all I want without wondering or worrying if you'll ever write me back. Maybe one day when you return home and apologise for having forgotten all about me and we kiss and make up, I'll show this to you and we can read it and laugh. Or maybe I'll decide that Journal Max is way cooler than Reality Max and you'll just have to live in here forever as my little imaginary former current best friend, Pen Pal. Time will wait and tell. Max, ready? So, Mum suggests taking a road trip next summer, and I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David, the wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on Mum and has stuck around like a bad zit. David, the moustache monster from Planet Dip. Max, so you know how I stopped going to class so much? Like, you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story, I had trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just didn't. I just didn't show up. And it's fine! Nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right?
Chloe! Wakey-wakey, eggs and bacon!
Last night, seeing Firewalk live...
Miming.
The skeevy assholes... That... girl... Was that really Rachel Amber?
Maybe.
You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Blah. Well, Max has abandoned us. If I ever see her again, I'm gonna guilt trip her so much. Maybe I'll make friends with that new girl I met at the club last night.
Better living through chemistry.
I don't get it. Probably a drug thing. What's this?
That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real?
Warren Graham.
Yay!
Chloe? That's me. Hayden. Zach and Trevor.
Logan.
And Alyssa. Justin. Elliot. I don't remember him. Dina. Evan. Stella. Lovely Stella. And Brooke. Hands off Warren. Juliet. Victoria. Nathan. Taylor. And Rachel Amber. No Kate. No Max. Not even Daniel. But lots of people we knew from the previous game. Not all of them are nice, though. It'd be nice to see some of them again.
Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town.
So this is where she found out about the gig and where to go. And someone here is talking about movies and nicknamed themselves the Doctor. Warren.
Wait, what? Who? What photo?
I'm tagged in a photo.
I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings.
Well, it's not such a bad photo. Could have been worse. Could have been tagged doing something foolish. Like poor Kate. Everyone wants to know who I am. They don't remember me. I took a school photo with half of them and they don't know who I am.
Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear.
I want a glowy bear.
Dad was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair.
You are great at science.
You dropped out of school, Chloe. But look, no pizza. You still have a chance to make things right. Or you could tear down the walls.
Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid. But then all the unicorns died.
Aww.
I want to ride a unicorn.
No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows.
Right, we're gonna graffiti.
Words of wisdom, don't fail me now.
Let's write, I like potatoes, or no, it's gotta be something anti-authority. I'm writing...
Just ask Steve Jobs.
Genius is 1% inspiration, 99% LSD.
Fun fact, shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
You ate your siblings in the womb?
Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
I want to listen to this CD. I mean, it's brilliant. It's probably got Lazy Town and all the best pirate songs.
As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
I do this. I saved every single ticket from all the shows I've ever been to. My first big one was Alice Cooper and Twisted Sister back in 2005.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome.
It was awesome.
I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to authority.
I used to skateboard. I don't seem to remember it ever being a rebellious thing.
I bet Long Max Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago.
Ha! If only you knew.
Nice one, Chloe. Mom's gonna love the new look.
Wear the eye patch on the mirror. Or maybe we can use this makeup and hide it. Bit of foundation, a bit of concealer. We'll look as good as new. Now what to wear? Ooh, bonus outfits.
Because I pre-ordered the game and got all the DLCs.
But now I get to look cooler than everyone else. Let's dress up as classic Chloe. Nice. That's the Chloe we all know. Apart from the brown hair. I think for now, we'll try something else. Maybe our new Firewalk t-shirt? Looking good. I like it. But it's still not right. We should totally have the option to dress as a pirate. Let's check these bonus outfits. Hot dog man. Oh my god! That sounds awesome! Are we going to be dressed in a giant hot dog costume? If not, we ought to be. No, just a t-shirt. But it looks good. It harks back to better days. Let's see what else we have. Punk dough. That sounds good. and we're looking good. I'm going to go for this one. We're best going to get breakfast. Joyce makes some good food.
I really should get going.
Yeah.
Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's.
I can't leave without my phone. I can't operate without my phone. What day is it? What time is it? Who knows?
Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it.
Ah, here we are, back here again. It's nice to explore familiar surroundings.
Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring?
Uh-oh, that's gonna cause drama. Do we really want to start fights with Joyce? Ugh, I hope David's not downstairs. Who's he think he is, with his moustache?
Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup.
To be honest, I'm surprised you don't want to conceal the black eye there, just to avoid an awkward conversation. I already know it's going to be drama as soon as we come downstairs.
Ah, Mom! Bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
Ah, yuck! That means they've been doing it like the pigeons! Let's just find our phone.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
Perhaps he has a side to him you haven't seen yet. We should find our phone before our breakfast gets cold. Maybe Joyce has made pancakes. So I don't want to miss out, because I like pancakes. Oh, we can hear our phone. It's time for the desperate scramble to find it.
Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby.
Oh no, it's quieter this way. Must be in the bathroom.
The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay.
Did I leave it in here?
Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray.
Fiendish. It's down the toilet! Oh no. Just down the side.
There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Let's have a look. One from Mum, one from Elliot. Will you be joining us for supper? No thanks. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Chloe, will you be home by curfew? There will be consequences. Uh-oh. What's Elliot say? Spanish test sucked! Lucky if I passed. Aw. Lo siento. No, I think I did okay. Cool. What are you up to? Not much. Got stuff to do later. Oh, okay. You finished the chem homework? Nope. That's the third time! I already know everything. Chloe just doesn't care. Uh-oh, Frank. The guy we saw last night. Let's see. Okay, so we've got stuff. But Chloe is out of money. And as we all know, Frank is her dealer. Drugs. 2010, so this game takes place 3 years before the original game. And we know at some point, Frank is going to start getting threatening. It's no surprise because Chloe owes him money and she's being a bit unreliable. Well, she's rich now from the money she stole last night. And by the way, I do not approve. And yes, I know I kind of told her to steal the money, but that's not the point. Hey, it's Max. Let's see what they have to say. So sorry, I've been bad about emailing. Texting is better for me anyway. It's Max. How's it going? You there? Ah, sorry again. I've been really busy. You love Seattle. More in a bit. Cool. Maybe some hitchhiking in my future? Hey, hippie. I'm so sorry. Maybe we should just set up a time to call. No worries. I'll check my dance card. It's 7 p.m. in Arcadia Bay. What is it, 2019 in Seattle? I know, right? Maybe this weekend. Sure, any time. Let me know.
Yo,
Queen of the Crickets. What's the latest? Max? Wow, Max is really bad at keeping in contact.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
It's no wonder Chloe has such an angsty, crazy journal.
Max is a bad friend.
And Chloe feels abandoned. But I'm sure Chloe's going to make a new friend very soon.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
I think we're in trouble. Let's go downstairs and find out.
Coming, Mom.